Hey there folks, John here with Through My Lens, and today I'm coming to you with another knife-related video. Today I'm going to be doing an unboxing of the Shirogorov F3 NS. Now, just a couple of weeks ago, I posted a video of my 2020 Top 5 Grails. And in that video, I did indicate that for 2021, I would probably be on the lookout for another Shirogorov, I thought perhaps a hot heat. But this F3 NS came up at Recon 1, and there were some qualities about it that looked really interesting to me, so I went ahead and pulled the trigger on it. It was almost an impulse buy, if you will. So I'm not entirely sure that it's one that I'm going to keep that's going to be in the permanent collection, but I am excited to take a look. I've got my brand new compact Gear X utility knife here that I'm going to be used to opening it. I will say I am kind of surprised that Recon 1 sent this in a FedEx envelope, particularly given that this is about a $900 knife, and it was just sent in a FedEx envelope and not a box. So that was a little bit of a surprise, but we'll go ahead and get this open. I've got it turned over to, of course, not show any address information. That should do it. Let's see what's in the package here. Oh, well, okay, that makes a lot more sense. They did package this in an additional box, which is a good thing. Let me go ahead and get this back open. And I will, let's see, I don't want to cut the box that's inside, of course. So I want to be very careful. And of course, this utility knife is very sharp. Let's see if that's enough to just kind of pull this open. There we go. There's actually should be two things in here. Yes, there are. Because I also went ahead and I ordered one of the utility tools. I'm guessing that's what this is. So let's see if we can get this open first. Yeah, I guess it was rather silly of me to be at all concerned about the fact that it was in a FedEx bag and not a box, because boy, is this darn well packaged. Wow. Boy, this is certainly impressively packaged. Which, of course, is a blessing and a curse all at the same time. There we go. Okay. Finally got to the point where I can pull the box out. Yeah, so fans of Through My Lens will know that earlier this year I got a Shirogorov Hatyan Zero. Let me go ahead and zoom in here a little bit better. And was more impressed with that than I thought I would be. It's one of the reasons why I decided to go ahead and get another Shirogorov. And this packaging, outside the packing that Recon 1 did, this packaging is very similar, if not identical, to what I saw with the Hatyan Zero, which of course was pretty unimpressive to me for this price point. They really do need to up their packaging game, I think. So here is the nice authenticity certificate that you get. And you can see this is an F3 NS Blades M390. The handle is in blue carbon fiber, which is one of the things that really reached out and grabbed me about this particular example. So let's take a look at that. Oh my goodness. Wow. This is stunning. Wow. And take a look. Not only does it have the blue carbon fiber, but it has a blue anodized backspacer, which is really nice, as well as a blue anodized sculptured clip. Here's that first flip. Let's see what kind of action we got here. That is nice. That is really nice. Gorgeous. Boy, there's a lot of belly on that blade. That is, boy, I like that a lot. Wow. That is impressive. It's got some heft to it as well. That is really, really nice flipping action. Very, very impressive. Wow. That is just stunningly gorgeous. I did not know that it was going to look that nice. And it's more, I thought the blue would be more subtle and kind of woven in with the black, but the blue seems to be really dominant in this, which again is really kind of a surprise. Interesting. Let's go ahead and unbox the tool that I bought as well. One of the things when I did my review of the Hatian Zero that I kind of lamented is, of course, the proprietary hardware and the fact that I had a hard time in my attempt to do a disassembly on it. I was unsuccessful in that attempt. So I'm hoping getting a tool will help out in that regard. And these are not cheap. I bought one of the pens, I believe this is going to be an actual writing instrument, not just a takedown tool. And it looks like it does come in a similar box to what the knives come in. There we go. See if I can get this open without unduly tearing anything. And it's small and difficult to grasp. My dislike of Shirogorov packaging only increases. All right, there we go. So this also comes in a Shirogorov cloth. There we are. Let's see if I can get my camera to focus here. There we go. It's pretty neat. So let me see, the pen doesn't pull off. Okay, yep, it's an actual writing instrument. So there's the pen part of it. And I believe it's titanium. I'm not sure. It is darn light. And it looks like by unscrewing maybe this end, yeah, you get to the bits. So it's got adjustment bits so that you can do work on the actual knife. That's pretty nifty. I'm going to put that back, and I'll probably play around with that a little while, but this pen is pretty cool. I like it. But, man, I don't know what this is made of, but I guess it's titanium? It is very, very light, and it's... I'm almost thinking it's aluminum, but I have to be wrong about that. I want to believe it's titanium, because gosh, this thing was about $300 all on its own. So really, pretty neat. But very, very impressed. Initial impressions of the F3 NS and the Shirogorov pen is also pretty interesting. I look forward to playing with that a little bit more. Well, there you have it. There's my unboxing of the Shirogorov F3 NS in blue carbon fiber. Hope you've enjoyed this video. Take care. God bless. We'll see you in the next one. I hope you've enjoyed this production from the Through My Lens YouTube channel. If you did, please click on the like button and do share the video on social media. If you'd like to see more content like it, please do subscribe to the channel, follow me on Instagram and Facebook, and do check out Through My Lens at www.throughmylens.org.